step and mien. His bride was like a village maid. Maude Clare was like a queen. Son Thomas, his mama said, with smiles almost with tears, "May Nell and you live but as true as we have done for years. Your father 30 years ago had just this tale to tell, but he was not so pale as you, nor I as pale as strife, and Nell was pale with pride. The boy gazed long on fair Maude Clare, all while he kissed his bride. "Oh, I have brought my gift, I brought my gift," she said, "to bless the hearth, to bless the board, to bless the marriage bed. Here's my half of the golden chain you wore about your neck the day we waited ankle deep for lilies the bag. Here's my half of the faded leaves we plucked from budding bough. With feet amongst the lily leaves, lilies are budding now. Maude Clare, Maude Clare, Maude Clare." He strove to match her scorn with scorn. He faltered in his place. "Just wait," he said, "Maude Clare," he said, "Maude Clare," and hid his face. She turned to Nell, "And now, my dear, I've got a gift for you. Though were it fruit, the blooms were gone, nor were it flowers due. Take my share of a fickle heart, mine of a paltry love. Take it or leave it as you will, I wash my hands thereof. And what you spurn, I'll wear. For he's my boy, for better and worse, and I love him, Maude Clare. And though you're taller by the head, more wise and far more fair, I'll love him till he loves me best of all."